And Enoch came and told her about Mordecai. She was in great distress. She sent clothes for him to put on instead of his sackcloth, but he would not accept them. 5. When Esther summoned Hanath, one of the king's eunuchs, assigned to attend her, and ordered him to find out what was troubling Mordecai and why. 6. So Hanath went out to Mordecai in the open square of the city in front of the king's gate. 7. Mordecai told him everything that had happened to him, including the exact amount of money Haman had promised to pay into the royal treasury for the destruction of Jews. 8. He also gave him a copy of the text of the edict for their annihilation, which had been published in Susa, to show to Esther and explain it to her. And he told him to urge her to go into the king's presence to beg for mercy and plead with him for her people. 9. Hanan went back and reported to Esther what Mordecai had said. 10. Then she instructed him to say to Mordecai. 11. All the king's officials and the people of the royal provinces know that for any man or woman who approaches the king in the inner court without being summoned, the king has but one law, that he be put to death. The only exception to this is for the king to extend the gold stretcher to him and spare him his life. But 30 days has passed since I was called to go to the king. 12. When Esther's word was reported to Mordecai, he sent back his answer. Do not think that people you are in the king's house, you alone of all the Jews will accept. 14. For if you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will arise from another place, but you and your father's family will perish. And who knows but that you have come to royal position for such time as this. 15. Then Esther sent his reply to Mordecai. 16. Go gather together all the Jews who are in Susa and fast for me. Do not eat or drink for 3 days, night or day. I and my maids will fast as you do. When this is done, I will go to the king, even though it is against the law, and if I perish, I perish. 17. So Mordecai went away and carried out all of Esther's instruction. 15, verse 1. On the third day, Esther put on the royal robes.
Chapter 5, verse 1.
Okay. Chapter 5, verse 1, the same thing, Esther. Mm-hmm. On the third day, Esther put on her royal robes and stood in the inner court of the palace in front of the king's hall. The king was sitting on his royal throne in the hall facing the entrance. 2. When he saw queen with her and held out her the gold spread, and touch the tip of the spread. That's the word of the Lord. Be blessed.
Amen. Hallelujah. Be blessed, my twins. Let us have our seats. Hallelujah. Be blessed, Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Najua tumeshawahi sikia hili neno, lakini tusikue wa kulizoea. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Wacha likuwe jipya asubuhi ya leo na mchana wa leo kwa maisha yako. Ruhusu tena Mungu akuzungumzie ama kunenee kuhusu hili neno. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa sababu ukilizoea unaweza toka vile ulivyo, lakini ukipatia Mungu nafasi nyingine na useme hili neno ni jipya asubuhi ya leo, Mungu nataka uninene na atakunenea na atakutendea. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Nataka tu kurudia mstari wa Esther chapter 4 verse 16. Tulipokuwa tunaanza hii wiki, Mungu alikuwa ametunenea na akasema ya kwamba anataka tufunge kwa maombi na tufunge in Esther style. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. That we fast in Esther style. So we did it in chain fasting and we give God the glory. So I will read the verse, Esther chapter 4 verse 16. Go gather all the Jews who are present in Shushan and fast for me, neither eat nor drink for 3 days, night or day. My mates and I will fast likewise, and so I will go to the king, which is against the law, and if I perish, I perish. And verse 17 it says, now this is Esther and this is Mordecai. So Mordecai went his way and did according to all that Esther commanded him. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you, Jehovah God, for your word. We magnify your name, King of all glory, because you are great God. Father, you are the supreme God of our Father, Lord. I'm just a vessel, King of all glory. May you pour a remashena in tela bakozina yandela baza. Raba sheke tana mayando dogo kozina. Ye ketala baboze ketala mayana. Rimayonda la bakusa in tela bazina. To the glory and honor of your name. May you be glorified, O God. May you touch us, King of all glory. To the glory and honor of your name, O God. We bless you and we love you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we do pray and believe and we give thanks. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Tumesoma hadithi, ama tumesoma neno la Mungu, ambalo ni neno ambalo liko na uhai. Na hilo neno tumesoma kwa kitabu cha Esther. Tunaona Esther alikuwa ni mama ambaye ni wa mpangilio. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Mama ambaye alikuwa ni wa mpangilio na anajua kupanga mambo yake vizuri. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na kichwa chetu kinasema hivi, be a good wife and a good husband. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise God. Be a good wife and a good husband. And to our son, be a good son and a good daughter. Praise Jesus. So, upate kitu chako hapo ndani. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hivyo tunaona ya kwamba, in Esther chapter 4 verse 16, imetuambia ya kwamba, Esther wakati alipoona mambo hayaendi sawa, aliweza kupanga ili akakusanye tuseme sasa tuchukue ni Wakristo wa hii nchi, ama tuseme ni Bethel, daughters of Zion of Bethel. Praise God. Lakini pia neno linatuambia kulikuwa na Mordecai. Praise Jesus. Na kulikuwa na Jews. Praise God. So the message haikukua ya wamama peke yake. Message ilikuwa ya Jews wote. Jews leo ni sisi wa Kristo. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ama Jew ni mimi na wewe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hivyo, kwa huyu mama anafurahisha vile alivyopanga mambo yake. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hivyo inatupasa, kwa mambo mengine ambayo tunamtarajia Mungu atende, yanaweza kuonekana magumu, lakini kwa Mungu hakuna lile jambo ambalo limemshinda. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na wakati Esther alipochukua hatua ya kufunga na kuomba,
alikuwa anaongea na Mordekai ambaye alikuwa ni mjomba yake. Praise Jesus. Mordekai was his uncle. Alikuwa uncle yake. Praise Jesus. Priscilla, you are blessed. Amen. And in verse 2, it tells us, Esther chapter 4, verse 2. He went as far as the front of the king's gate, for no one might enter the king's gate clothed with sackcloth. Verse 3, it tells us, and in every province was the king's command and decree arrived there was great mourning among the Jew with fasting, weeping, and wailing, and many lay in sackcloth and ashes. Praise Jesus. Amen. The cloth of sackcloth, it means humility. Praise God. Unaweza kusa kuvaa hiyo nguo ya gunia lakini uwe umeenda mbele ya Mungu ukiwa umenyenyekea. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hiyo hiyo nguo ya gunia inamaanisha nimeacha mambo yangu, nimeacha vitu zangu ama nimeacha kazi zangu, sasa nimeingia kwa kazi hii nyingine. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ambayo ni kazi ya kufunga na kuomba. Kwa hiyo inamaanisha nimetoka, nimeacha yale mambo ambayo nilikuwa nafanya. Nimeingia na nimevaa ile vazi ambalo la kunyenyekea. Praise God. Na tunaambiwa pia walikuwa wamejipaka jivu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Pia jivu inakuja kwamba yani hutaki kuonekane vile, tuseme kama labda ni kazi zile ambazo labda unafanya kwa niseme ukiwa unatumia nguvu sana, bado inaleta unyenyekevu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Niposa yani uweze kunyenyekea ukienda mbele za Mungu, upate kibali mbele za Mungu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And in verse 4, it tells us, so Esther, that is Esther chapter 4 verse 4, so Esther and maids and aunties came and told her, and the queen was deeply distressed when she went. She sent garments to clothe Mordecai, take his sackcloth away from him, but he will not accept them. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Sijui ukiwa kama mama ama ukiwa mzee, ukiwa kama daughters of Zion ama ukiwa team Israel, ukiwa royal priesthood, sijui ni yani kile ambacho Mungu anatuzungumzia leo, sijui umechukua haya maneno yakiwa vipi. Mimi nimeachukua yakiwa hivi. Kuna hali nyingine inaweza tupasa tukusanyike na tuombe na tukiwa na umoja. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ndio tunaweza kosa kukua labda kundi nzima la kanisa, lakini naweza chukua royal priesthood, naweza chukua team Israel. Tuseme kuna jambo fulani nasi anapitia, ama kuna jambo fulani Pastor Martin anapitia, ama kuna jambo fulani ama Julia anapitia, na niposa tumeona likiwa ligumu, nikana kwamba linatusukuma kwa kona. Lakini wakati tunapopanga mipango ambayo ni mipango ya maombi, Bwana Yesu asifiwe, Mungu anaingilia kati. Praise Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You don't go to God with pride. Praise Jesus. Amen. And that's why we are being told that they were walivaa nguo za gunia. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So auendi ukiwa umejiinua. Na wakati unapofunga na kuomba, it means you don't eat. Praise Jesus. According to the agreement. Hallelujah. The agreement of team. As we agreed that we will do chain fasting. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. And there is something God doing. There is something God has done in our that expressed Jesus. As the way we see the story of Esther and Mordecai and the people of Jew, praise Jesus. Walikutana wakakusanyika pamoja. Esther alipotumiwa kama chombo, alisema nitawakusanya kwa njia nzuri, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Because there is opposite of Esther, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. If you desire to be opposite, it is wrong. Praise Jesus. Desire to be a Esther, a good Esther of today. Praise Jesus. Wakukusanyika, wakuleta upendo, wakuambia watu kuhusu Mungu, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kama kuna janga kwa nchi yenu, ama kama kuna janga kwa kijiji, bado kuwa Esther. Kusanya, ambia Augustine, tukutane leo pamoja ili tuombee fulani. Ambia Mama Julia, tukutane leo ili tuombee jambo fulani. Ambia Pastor Winnie, tukutane leo ili tuombee jambo fulani. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Choose to be a good Esther of today, praise Jesus, and not the bad Esther. Hallelujah. Because the bad Esther, tasema wacha ikae. Wacha kama ni kuharibika, kuharibike. Wacha kama ni iondoke, kuvunjika, ivunjike. But in us, we are the gate of heaven, praise Jesus. We cannot go against our God. We go according to His word, praise Jesus. Humble yourself before God. Hallelujah. Humble yourself before God. We see the humility of Esther. Mahali ilipompeleka. When you humble yourself to your before God, God will uplift you. Praise Jesus. When you humble yourself before God, God, He will uplift you. Hallelujah. And in Esther chapter 4, verse 7, it tells us, hallelujah. And Mordecai told him all that had happened to him and the sum of money that Haman had promised to pay into the king's treasuries to destroy the Jews. Praise Jesus. And in verse 8 it tells us, he also gave him a copy of the written decree for the destruction. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So I have said earlier that you choose to be Esther, a good Esther, and when you choose to be a bad Esther, we see the way Haman is planning against Esther. Praise Jesus. But today, we have come to declare that our God, He is alive. Praise Jesus. It doesn't matter what Haman has paid for the enemy for me to be destroyed. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter the sacrifice. Because there is this sacrifice which Jesus prayed on the cross. Hallelujah. Ile ambayo haiwezi linganishwa na dhabihu yoyote. It is more than enough, praise Jesus. So today I have come to say that, or we have come to say that, we are the Esther of today. And hatutakaa chini tukiangalia Haman akiharibu, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Tutakaa chini tukiangalia Mungu akitengeza, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So I want to tell you to tell yourself today that anything that Haman has paid for you, it is not going to work. Hallelujah. Haitafanya kazi kwa maisha yangu ama kwa maisha yako, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Because Jesus has died for us on the cross and He has paid everything for us, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter. The
spirit. We see that even if Haman paid this sacrifice of money, God did not honor his sacrifice. God honored the sacrifice of Esther. Praise Jesus. So the service that you have been giving God, God is honoring it today. Praise Jesus. The prayer that you have been giving to God, that you have been praying, that you have been fasting, maybe you are praying and worship. You have been praising, you have been worshiping. God is ready to reward you today. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. If the enemy can give sacrifice to Satan, what is your sacrifice to God today? Hallelujah. We see Haman giving the sacrifice for Jews, for Esther and Mordecai to be destroyed. What is your sacrifice towards God today? Praise Jesus. Dhabihu yako ni gani mbele za Mungu leo? Kwa sababu tunaona Esther, Haman amepeana kitu ndiposa mimi nisiweze kuishi vile naishi, ama maisha yangu yakae vibaya. Opposite, I am supposed to give God more. Praise Jesus. If it is praise, it is to praise. Kama ni kuworship, ni kuworship. If it is to dance, dance. Kama ni vile pastor anapiga piano, anamchezea Mungu, mchezee. That is a great sacrifice. Praise Jesus. And there is another sacrifice of cash. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. So don't come to God empty-handed. Don't come to house of God empty-handed. Praise Jesus. Because we see Haman giving sacrifice to the enemy. So us, we don't give to the enemy. Us, we give to our God who is a living God. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. And I have come to declare this, that the sacrifice that the enemy has been giving, or the enemy has given towards your life, it is not going to destroy you. Praise Jesus. Because God of Esther, he is alive and he is here. Hallelujah. You will live to see the faithfulness of God. Praise Jesus. Maisha yako ni zaidi ya kile shetani amekupangia. Praise Jesus. And I have come to declare that our marriages will stand in the name of Jesus Christ. No matter what the enemy has paid, we have the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise Jesus. Our children, they will stand. Praise Jesus. Our nation, it will stand to praise the living God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Our children, they will live to serve God. Hallelujah. Our generation, they will serve the mighty God. Praise Jesus. Because our God lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And in Esther chapter 4 verse 11, it tells us. Let us read together. All the king's servants and the people of the king's province know that any man or woman who goes into the inner court to the king who has not been called, he has but one law put all to death, except one to whom the king holds out the golden scepter, that he may live. Yet I myself have not been called to go in to the king's to the king these 30 days. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. We see a woman and a man. Praise Jesus. A daughter and a son. A team Israel and a daughter of Zion. Praise Jesus. We see the unity. A man and a woman. Praise Jesus. Tuyengo pande huo mwingine. So as a ministry, let us come together na tuchoche kile ambacho Mungu amekieka mbele yetu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Let us come together, a daughter of Zion and a team Israel, a royal priesthood, come together and support whatever God has dropped in the Esther. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Because we have a vision. And in that vision, there is a vision bearer. Praise Jesus. Amen. We have our spiritual parents. So let us be the Esther of today. Support the work of God in them. Because when you support the vision, you will come out with a something great. When I saw the period, you will be elevated one level to another. Praise Jesus. When you be an Esther to the vision, you will be blessed. Praise Jesus. You will be healed. Praise Jesus. Your children will be blessed in the name of Jesus. So let us come together as Esther did and Mordecai. Support the vision and you will see the greatness of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We were taught somewhere, praise Jesus. Hallelujah. It is the daughters of Zion week, praise Jesus. A husband is very important in a marriage, praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Mzee ni muhimu sana. Ama mume wako ni muhimu sana. Ama mke wako ni muhimu sana kwa ndoa, kwa Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hivyo, tunataka kuheshimu wazee wetu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. If I manage to respect my husband, if I manage to inasemaje, kama ninaweza nyenyekea, submission, praise Jesus. If I manage to submit and to respect my husband, it is very easy for me to submit and to respect the ministry, praise Jesus. And to respect the authority, praise Jesus. So as God is teaching us to submit and to respect our husband, we have no choice. Hallelujah. Hatuna kitu kingine cha kubadilisha na hiyo. We have to submit to our husbands. We have to respect them. Praise Jesus. We have to love them and to show them the God whom we love. Praise Jesus. Kwa hivyo tuwapende. Kama sitaweza kumpenda, siwezi penda Mungu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na siwezi penda yule jirani yangu. Kwa hivyo nikiweza kupenda mume wangu na nikimheshimu na nikinyenyekea, kuna urahisi wa kuweza kunyenyekea chini ya Reverend Anne. Praise Jesus. Tusiruhusu kiburi kikuje juu yetu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I know it is not easy, but pray that God, he will help us and give us the spirit of humility and submission and respect towards our husbands. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We love you, Team Israel. Praise Jesus. Amen. I love my husband wherever he is. Hallelujah. Amen. I respect him. Praise Jesus. Yes, I am married with one husband. Praise God. And I'm blessed with children. Hallelujah. Because without a man, it is not a marriage. Praise God.
Yeah, so I love him very much. Praise Jesus. Yeah. And when you show love to your husband, some things automatic start coming. Praise Jesus. Yeah. There was a time, praise God, that just allowed me to speak something. But it is not something bad. Some time back, I sat down with Dad. Na Dad akaniambia, nasikia ni kama nilikuwa naongea na yeye sasa kuna kitu hiki na hiki na kile kinanisumbua kwa ndoa yangu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na wakati nilipoanza kuongea na yeye akaniambia, na feel uko na spirit ya anga. Praise Jesus. Ni ukweli. Hallelujah. But it was that time. Praise Jesus. And from that time nikaanza kuambia Mungu, ukweli Dad amesema, he is my spiritual father. God allow me to come out of anger. Praise Jesus. Because when you are rectified or when you are corrected, just try your best. Start with prayers. And when something comes, tell Holy Spirit to lower you down. Praise Jesus. And he told me something. When you are going to talk to your husband, lower your voice. Praise God. Hallelujah. Lower your voice. Sijui ni wangapi tunafanyanga hivyo. Hallelujah. Doctors of Zion, tuko. Sijui ni wangapi tunafanyanga hivyo. Tunafanyanga. Hallelujah. May God bless you. I thank God because of that Oscar. And I tried to come back to my senses. And I told God, I want to come out of anger. Praise God. And slowly by slowly, because some things they has the end to pop. Slowly by slowly, God started ministering to me and delivering me. Praise God. And I found myself having talk and a good talk. Praise God. And a good talk comes in a good good communication. Praise Jesus. Sijui kama nimeitoa vizuri. Communication. Praise Jesus. Your communication towards your husband matters a lot. Praise Jesus. When you go to your husband, lower your voice. Hallelujah. When he comes out, lower your voice. Be an envelope. Envelope. Ile ambayo anapenda kusema, anapenda kukaa kama bahasha. I know it is not easy. But when you try and you invite Holy Spirit, He will make you to manage to do those things which are impossible in your life. Hallelujah. Because Holy Spirit will make you to manage to do them. Hallelujah. So, when I went to my husband, I realized, yes. Na dada akanigemea na ukali. Na akaniambia next time tutaongea. Praise Jesus. Amen. And I love you, Dad. Hallelujah. So, iliendelea, tukaendelea kuongea. And I told God, I want to be changed. I want to be a good mother, an Esther of today, praise Jesus, who can produce something good in my marriage, praise God. And today I have a testimony, hallelujah, that we can talk with my husband, stories na tucheke, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. That is a great testimony. Of which haikuwa inawezekana hapo nyumae, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I bless God because I was the problem, praise God. So being the Esther of today, humble yourself and lower your voice before your husband and you will see the goodness of God. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. We come to this man Mordecai. Hallelujah. I love
this man. Mulinda lango.
Many times you can find a watchman na umpite because sijui kama yani kuna vile kazi yake ni kama huwa inaonekana ni kama sio kazi. Praise God. But kazi yake ni kazi. Kwa Mungu ni kazi. Praise God. Huyo mlinda lango, huyo Asha mwenye akopo kwa mlango. Hiyo kazi yake ni kazi mbele za Mungu. Huyo ambaye anayetengeneza maji. Hiyo kazi yake bado ni kazi, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And I bless God because of Mordecai. Praise Jesus. Choose to have the spirit of Mordecai today. Hallelujah. In your marriage, in your life, choose to have the spirit of Mordecai in your life. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because the spirit of Mordecai is humility. Praise God. Na tusimu tunawadharau. Kama umekuwa ukiona mulinda lango ama Asha na unampita tu, it's like hata hujaona mtu, kindly say hi. Praise God. Uingie. Na kama umeenda hata kama ni supermarket, umemkuta hapo, mwambie habari yako. Praise Jesus. You never know. Labda hapo ndio baraka zako ziko. Praise God. Hallelujah. Tumenyamaza sana. Hallelujah. Say hi to that Mordecai. Maybe your blessings are colored by that soldier in that gate. Praise Jesus. So don't despise Mordecai in your life. Praise Jesus. Accept to be Mordecai and to be used by God. Praise Jesus. Because we see Esther and Mordecai cooperating together. Hallelujah. We see Esther and Mordecai cooperating together to bring Jews together and to pray for the nation of Kenya and to pray for Bethel ministry and to pray for your village. Praise Jesus. And we see the fruit of salvation through their prayers. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. So today don't despise the Mordecai you see in your life. Hallelujah. Love that Mordecai. Appreciate that Mordecai. Praise Jesus. And God will uplift you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
We were taught somewhere breaking the limits. Hallelujah.
And because we are in the midst of the word of Esther, today God is going to break every limitation in our lives. Hallelujah. Say amen.
Amen.
He is going to break every limitation in our lives. In the word of God, we were taught in Ruth chapter 1 verse 14, but we will not read at this time. Tutasoma baadaye. Praise Jesus. So let us allow Holy Spirit to break every limitation. Because when I look at Mordecai, he allowed God to use him as a watchman, in the kingdom, but he was not just a watchman over one. He was watchman, spiritual and physical. Praise Jesus. So, in that position that God he has positioned you, decide to work it, to work in that position well, because we see the way Esther, she was elevated beyond the limitation. The way Mordecai, he was elevated beyond
Esther chapter 5. Chapter 5, verse 1. Verse 1, it tells us. Now it happened on the third day that Esther put on her royal robes and stood in the inner court, the king's place. Hallelujah. Huko hauingi ukiwa na vitu zako, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Vitu zako na maanisha aje? Vile vitu havimpendezi Mungu, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hiyo chuki. Hallelujah. That bitterness. You cannot enter in that inner court with your bitterness. Hautaingia. So you better leave it behind. Praise Jesus. And because we have come in his presence, and God he has assured us that he is going to break every limitation in our life. That limitation of anger, that is what limits you to go in the inner court, to fetch that clean water, to fetch your healing, to fetch your peace, to fetch your joy. Decide to leave that spirit of Haman out of your life and go in the inner court with the royal roots. Hallelujah. Mimi si mwalimu, but Holy Spirit will allow me. Hallelujah. Will teach me and will teach us today. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm just a vessel. Hallelujah. So choose to enter in. Choose to enter in the inner courts of the king's place with the royal robes. Hallelujah. And the word of God continue telling us. Across from the king's house, while the king sat on his royal throne, in his royal house, facing the entrance of the house. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And in verse 2 it tells us, so it was when the king saw Queen Esther standing in the court that she found favor in his sight, and the king held out to Esther the gold scepter that was in his hand. Then Esther went near and touched the toe of the scepter. In verse 3 it tells us, and the king said to her, what do you wish? Hallelujah. Will you stay the way God wants? Or will you live according to Holy Spirit? There is nothing too hard for God. Hallelujah. Amen. He will allow you because you live like him. Because you stay like Christ. He will allow you to enter in the inner court. Praise Jesus. Amen. Because in the inner court, that is where you take your favor. Praise Jesus. Amen. That is where you take your promotion. That is where you take your healing. Amen. That is where you take your peace. Amen. Praise Jesus. Amen. That is where you receive your joy. That is where you receive your peace. That is where you receive your promotion. That is where you receive your miracle. That is where you receive your happiness. Hallelujah. Amen. In the inner court, that is where you receive freedom. Hallelujah. Amen. In And when we started this week, Lord told us that He brought a vision of a chain, a very big chain, that daughters of Zion, God was setting us free. And immediately, when we were set free, somebody will go back and chain him or herself again and take himself or herself back. But I have come to declare that because this is the third day, the day of victory, we are no longer in chains in the name of Jesus Christ. We are no longer in bondage in the name of Jesus Christ. We are free in the name of Jesus Christ. Because our Jesus set us free on the cross and once and for all in the name of Jesus Christ. Yetarabo. Shereba kozika yanda. Yetarabo. Let us go in the book of Matthew. Yeah. Hallelujah. Oh Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. In Matthew chapter 28, verse 1 up to 6. Yeketa. Mashele bahanda laboza. Jesus, we love you. Now after Sabbath, as the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake. Underline that. Behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it. Verse 3, it tells us his countenance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. Hallelujah! And the guards shook for fear of him, and because like dead men, while he praise Jesus. And the guards shook for the fear of him and became like dead men. But the
radi ni ile mlio ngurumo. Ukiwa na umeme huwa unaleta mwangaza. Na tunaona lightning in Matthew 28 verse 3. We see lightning. So when we pray, God brings light. Hallelujah. When we are in unity, God brings light. Hallelujah. When we are in love, like we are together, I am together with my husband, or you are together with your husband, God brings light. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Yes, love for Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Receive all the glory, Jesus. Yes, I have a testimony about that light. Hallelujah. I know it is. It has been a journey. It has been a journey to me, to my marriage. Hallelujah. Because this is the day of daughters of Zion. I want to testify this. And I will use Swahili so that it can come out well. There was this duration of fasting for 40 days. And I decided to be one of them, but I'm not perfect. Praise Jesus. Part of fasting, praying and fasting. So it reached a time that my husband told me something. And this something amazed me, praise Jesus. And he told me something that I want us start praying in the morning, even if it is 15 minutes, praise Jesus. And I told my husband that it's okay, praise God. And I saw light in my marriage, praise Jesus. And hallelujah, yes, clap for Jesus. Hallelujah. And when we were praying, I could realize that we could come in agreement, praise Jesus, because we are praying together in the morning. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. We could pray before he goes out, and he could allow that, Mom, just pray for those 15 minutes and then I wake up and prepare myself and go. So that is agreement of two people in one, praise God. So it means we are in one accord, praise Jesus. But when we are not in one accord, things might come harder, praise Jesus. But God bring it, not because I am perfect, praise Jesus. Not because I am good, praise Jesus. Alileta kwa sababu yeye ni Mungu. Na alipoleta, nikaambia Mungu asante kwa kuleta hiyo zawadi, praise Jesus. So in this first dream we see this. His countenance was like lightning. Nikaona mwangaza, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And in the evening, he could come and tell me everything. Praise God. Aniambie kila kitu ambacho kimeendelea mchana. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And yale ambayo hatutaki tungepangua. Na yale ambayo tunaona ni ya Mungu, tungeweka agreement. Praise Jesus. See, we have been given power. Thank you. May God bless you. Yes. Hallelujah. So, in your marriage, in your school, in your family, because you have chosen to worship the living God, who is no longer in the grave, he has decided to bring light in your life. Praise Jesus. Jesus, he has decided to bring light in your life. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. He has decided to bring light in this ministry. He has decided to bring light in daughters of Zion. He has decided to bring light in royal priesthood.
He is no longer in the grave. He is reigning in heaven. And he is reigning in this place. So that today we are choosing to worship the living God, the God of Esther, the God of Ruth. We are choosing to submit under him because he is a powerful God. Hallelujah. We are taking this gospel because he has wrought.
Oh.